I'm slightly disorganized. You guys can hear me rolling around in my new wheelchair. A la Dr. Evil. Dropping nibs everywhere. I'm looking for my zero. Raging, so she was like, actually listen to what I'm streaming on Twitch. What? So much fun. So if you guys were not on my Facebook Live today, where were you? Probably working and many other things. Hello, Simmons! It's because you were watching her from the top. You've gotten used to watching her from the side. Now you are above me. So perspectives will be off for this, about as good as I can get it. Uh-oh, the other one's getting out of bed. Supposed to be. Totally nailed it. Well, we didn't want to disappoint, did we?
Sorry, I was trying to use
restroom. Huh? You were trying to what? Video camera open doors. No, she's fine. She's fine. There's no other camera. I just have it above. You saw my studio. We're going to try to work on making sure that we come in on Wednesdays. So. That's what we're working on. It's done. It's over. It's so over. We're working on it. It's a work in progress. Getting used to doing a schedule between softball practice and gymnastics and school plays and all of that. I mean, come on. I got stuffs happenings. And I'm putting down a zero first, and I'm going in here, and what I did was I took the Copic marker ink, and these are like watercolor brushes that you can fill up with the ink. Most of the time, watercolor artists fill it up with water and paint. Just do a little cheat here. Saves my nibs and creates a nice even layout. Hey, Pookie! How are you, darling? Missed you. We're all like, Pookie! Lately, I've been feeling very angsty, so I've been listening to Lithium on Sirius XM. It's kind of taking me back to my high school days. I used to sit there and listen to all of this stuff, be all angsty in my room, and be like, I'm gonna draw comics for a living. I know, she told me. So basically, Scott's come in. He says he's been talking with Simone. Simone! We are discussing pre-comic book day. And if you guys didn't know, Scott owns a comic book shop in Biloxi called Three Alarm Comics, which makes sense for the name. Totally cool, folks. Love them all. They're meowsing. Group of people. And if you're in that area, you should definitely check them out. If you are not, then you should go online and support a shop that is awesome. That's so cool! Scott just said that we have Ming Chin coming. Excuse me, I can't read. He's going to be there on Free Comic Book Day. He is on the TV show Comic Book Men. I actually listen to that TV show in the background sometimes when I'm working because it reminds me of sitting in the comic book shop and just listening to the guys just shoot the stuff. Excuse me. I'm trying to watch my pot math. And yeah, that show's really fun to listen to. The whole versus conversation. Who would win? I remember listening in on those. Yes, support your local stores. Free Comic Book Day is coming on Cinco de Mayo, actually, I believe. Right? Oh, he's a genuinely nice guy. That's awesome. I would think that, on a show like that, they would be pretty genuine to who they are. They're not like it's not like, housewife show or something. Yes, comics and beer and margaritas. Now I'm going in with a zero. Doing happy little clouds. Happy little clouds. Just little happy clouds here. Does he do Twitch? Get his butt in here. I got Sanders all of a sudden. So you guys, Emerald City Comic Con, it was great. The end of the show, I just wanted to just have a good old margarita and just relax. And we went to a sushi place that had little cars that took your food to your table. It was awesome. And Simone and Mike took me there, and we had so much fun. But I ordered a margarita, and Simone had really never had margaritas, I guess, or maybe just never had a really good one. It was a decent margarita. But yeah, I think it hit you a little hard. Yeah, no, sometimes some margaritas are, yeah. Uh-oh. It was, yeah, it hit you like a ton of bricks. It was great. You were like, it was fun. You were so goofy. And after a while, I was like, Simone, go to sleep. You need to go to bed. And you're like, what? I am tired. It was awesome. Oh, yeah. No, I'm not saying you were drunk. You were just very happy-go-lucky and It was a good time for you to go to sleep because if you had stayed up and drank more margaritas, then you would have gotten not happy. All I could tell. Oh, fun times, fun times. So, Scott, if I'm able to make it there for free comic book day, I expect some nice margaritas. You know, because I'm a diva like that. When I show up, I blow in on any more margaritas. Shane made me. I like this other thing called a Paloma, which is basically just kind of a lighter type of margarita. It's really yum yum. Really yum yum. Yes, only green M&Ms. No W's, please. I know, where's the Shane?
We are joining our Precious Wednesday. Would you like something from Cat Box? Get something out of the Cat Box.
I don't know if he'll be able to make it or not, because it also depends on childcare and stuff. And Cinco de Mayo is actually our wedding reenactment anniversary. No W's in the M&Ms. Think about that. Yeah, it's a long drive, so we have to figure that out. But it would still be really cool to go. Apologize. I'm trying to get good camera placement because I work at this angle. So you guys are like this. My paper is sideways. So I've got you as good as I can get you in order to be able to see what I'm doing. And I'm going to have a sip of wine. Other colors. Oh, I see your face. I know, I know. You guys are awesome. Yeah, that's just me being obnoxious, Simone. Because I like to force people to be like, wait a minute, what? Oh, yeah. Always. What am I not? Shane got really excited because he saw the inks of another piece that I'm working on. Yeah, no C2E2 this year. Childcare stuff again. Oh, Theo, yes. Theo is great. You folks don't know who we're talking about. Theo played on Walking Dead, I believe, like the first and second season, right? He's also played on the show Roots, but he's this very tall, very talented black man, and he is awesome and funny as all heck. And if you guys have ever met my husband, he is very pale. Theo grabbed my husband and said, "We're going to sing Ebony and Ivory." And they did. Awesome that you got your zombies versus cheerleader. Thank you. Well, I don't know. We'll always have Twitch. Yes. That was Shane was like, "Wait a minute, you have a live auction tonight." We're like, "Nope, because we have Twitch." There's a live auction going on tomorrow on my Facebook page. So if you guys are wanting some merchandise, hit me up. Be tomorrow night, probably 9:30 Eastern Standard Time. All right. Sure, I'll give you a call. Everybody say good night to Scott. Had no idea Smashing Pumpkins did a cover of this song. Seen all our old friends. Monkey poo green. They're a weird color, but it works. No regrets, no regrets. So many regrets. Oh, we just want to finish this up. Having fun rendering her. I just finished watching Jessica Jones, actually. It's very good. Sad, but good. I won't give any spoilers away, but wow. I've actually watched them all, just because I like watching them. I think it's pretty cool to see how their interpretations. Although, oh no, I take that back. I couldn't watch Iron Fist just because the guy was way too whiny, and he was ends up like, nobody likes me, nobody's my friend. So I couldn't watch that one. But yeah, I watched Jessica Jones recently because that's one of my favorites. Yes, it was. I mean, season one was pretty cool. But this one is pretty intense. So, again, I won't spoil anything for you. Yeah, he's like, I have an iron fist, and then he just wanders around. He's like, nobody's my friend. Everybody's mean to me. It's like, dude, really? I think the only thing redeeming about Iron Fist is all of his supporting cast is pretty good and incredible, but he is just bad. They're pretty good. Punisher was pretty cool. It touched on some sensitive topics. Exactly. Like, again, with that one, the supporting cast was so much better than the lead character, and still is. Like, even with the team up of the defenders and stuff, it just he was just like the little lost boy wandering around. But Jessica Jones still is by far my favorite out of all of them. So washed out. Hold on. Oh, he wasn't alone. He was raised by monks or whatever. I don't know. I just told Shayna when we were watching all of these, like, with the whole kind of 80s stuff coming back with the Ninja Turtles, and then you got Iron Fist, and then all of this, and all these groups are like the foot, the fist, the hand. I'm like, well, what's the next group going to be called? The knee? The new bad guys? Watch out for the elbow. What was with the 90s and the body parts? Gang names. Didn't quite make sense. men. It just like, what in the world? But that was that was back in the '80s and stuff with all of this stuff. They weren't very creative. Okay, we have group bad guys. What are we gonna name them? The Foot. All right, that sounds good. Yeah, that's what this whole gang is gonna be. That's gonna be really dangerous. It's gonna be quite intimidating. Jock strap. No, no one wants to get punched by the jock strap. And you just go Austin Powers. Wing, pay attention. Willie Nelson? Again, like I said, they were not very imaginative. Mostly me, but mostly you. So wrong, so wrong.
Has been broadcasting live from South by Southwest in Austin this week. She's wrapping up at about 10 o'clock Eastern, so very soon, not much longer from now, on XMU, that is on Channel 35, and she's kind of exhausted. I mean, have you been to any festivals? Have you really gone from stage to stage? Have you hung out with bands backstage and talked to them live on the air, and then, oh, wait a minute, someone can come talk to you right now? That's what Jenny is doing. I'm certain she's keeping it all clean and G-rated the whole time. Yeah. It's happening until 10 o'clock, and it's between noon and 7 for Flood Fest on XMU.
On her. I'm doing. Kind of bounce all over the place as I let stuff dry. This is going to be a print. Just like the Morgan piece was a print, but then she went to auction. She can go, she can go up for auction tomorrow, but she will be, you know, full price. Which most of the time when people are here, auctions and stuff, they're wanting to get a good deal. But Mercy is up for sale if anyone wants to buy the original. I know. C2E2, I hear ya. But there's next year. There's also commissions that we will open up one at a time. Nice! The Lady Death Treasure Edition. Oh, fun! Yeah! Sweet! Brian was actually checking out my colors. Uh-oh, Sirius is skipping. So we'll see if that anything comes from that. That would be cool. But it looks like Brian is going to try to make it to Pensacon for next year, which would be really awesome. And when I'm speaking of Brian, I'm talking about Brian Polito from Coffin Comics. Maybe will I flip this around? And he goes to Pensacon. We're going to try to do some fun stuff for that show, too. It's a local show for me. We've got some other Lady Deaths and La Muertas coming down the pipeline. A lot of my stuff that I just recently did for them is gone to color. So expect to see some more of my artwork coming through Coffin Comics. And then I've got another Kickstarter campaign of a company that's doing their own book called Patriotica. And I'll be doing a kind of dinosaur cover for that one. It's going to be fun. That one's probably going to be covered. Whoop, sorry. Colored by Lemos. I am a traditional artist, so the only type of digital stuff that I do is I do have a tablet. It's one that I use as both a laptop and a work tablet. And I will kind of do roughs in it, but I don't do anything more. I'm about to go and do something. Because I prefer to get my hands dirty. Yes. Yes. Yeah, and his name is Ron. Have fun. That's pretty cool. Yeah, I had Wacom approach me and ask me to do a demo, and I'm all like, oh. Like, can I color on it with markers? I don't know. What do you want? What am I going to do? But I told them I would be happy to show them how I rough digitally, but then it would just be rough sketches. It wouldn't be a finished product. Okay, these wings kind of turn orange on the tip. Okay. Well, then get yourself a kneaded eraser. They don't leave little pieces all over the place. They don't erase as well, but you can get the majority of the stuff off without having a problem getting stuff everywhere. And then that's part of the fun to me, is getting your fingers dirty. Yeah, I mean, kneaded erasers are great for that, to do just like a general pass to get most of the lines off. But I mean, I know I'm very heavy-handed too, like with all my stuff. That I think that's why I can't do watercolors, because I press down too hard. I am not gentle with my art supplies, and I make an ever-loving mess. I don't know if you heard, my husband came in here and then he kind of had a mild aneurysm and then slowly walked away, because being in the middle of projects, it's a mess. And not just that, coming home from a show and then just all we did was just throw things in here. There's bags, I can barely turn around, and I've been working. And if he tries to put up my markers, I'm like, no, I have them laid out in a certain way. We know what colors I've used. Don't. I turned it to Stuart from Matt TV. No. Let me do it. Thank you. mirror. No touchy. No touchy. It's like when my kids come in my studio, I'm like, don't touch anything. But no! Get out. Get out of here. Yeah. I have my markers grouped in certain areas all over the place. And then, of course, stuff is piled on tables. So it's ever-loving mess in here. Pretty soon it's going to get even too messy for me. Then I'll clean it. They needed erasers. Like if you, they're like those things, if you drop them on the floor, they get dust on them, then they can kind of get a little grody. But I mean, I've had my dog like attack some and try to use them as a chew toy, and I just sat there and worked it, and it was fine. Well, I'll use it. The dog ate my erasers. My excuse. I do what I can. Yeah, it took me a little bit. I was like, why do artists love kneaded erasers so much? And then I was like, oh, because they don't leave shavings everywhere. So, like, traveling, especially like in airports, they kind of frown at you for like shoving eraser bits all over the floor. I'm like, hey, what are you doing? And you're like, what? I'm trying to be creative. But that's just one solution. I mean, the digital tablet totally mixes all of that. Yeah, no can do. No, they don't like it. It was actually, I was drawing while waiting at the terminal between flights. I forgot which airport I was at. And I was totally into a sketch. I don't even remember what I was drawing in my little sketchbook at the time. But I was really into it, and I was, you know, I was digging into the paper because, again, like I said, I'm heavy-handed. So I needed to erase a lot once I got done inking it. And I started just, you know, laying into it, just going into town. Just... And I just went and started brushing the erasers everywhere. And then I looked up, and it's like this lady at the desk was glaring at me, like, "You mother!" I was like sitting there, and then I thought to myself, I was like, "Oh crap! I am so sorry. My bad." So like I'm just over there trying to scooch the little pieces out of the way, which only made it look worse, and it was just really awkward. So I'm like, I'm gonna go over here and get a yogurt, I guess. I don't know. I'm so sorry. I'm gonna put this book away. And you have a nice day. Okay, kind of personal question here, but I don't think I've ever met a female who like to use two different color nail polish. Is there any reason why you do, if you wouldn't mind answering? Thanks. Okay. Well, if you go on Pinterest, which is where I got this color combo and pattern, that was what I did. And I saw it and I thought it was pretty. And I told the nail person, I'm like, "Hey, can you do this?" And they're like, "Sure." And I was like, "Yay." So there you go. Just look at Pinterest. Jen secretly wants to be Jen. I like the two colors. I mean, it was something to be like, okay, but I like it. It was fun. It's fun times. I think on Pinterest they had a little design on these two, but I was like, nah, skip the design. I'm not paying extra for that. Because life's cheap like that. Thank you. Well, yeah, and they complement each other, so it's not like an eyesore. And I'm gonna get it changed here soon because they're getting a little long. I'm a nail biter, so I get the fake nails, so I get my nails did, and that's about my girly moment. Oh no, I can't do the long pointy nails. Actually, they're at the point where they're a little too long for me right now. You're funny. Nah, I just drink the wines. I'm drinking the wines right now. Woo woo. No, I don't like the pointy. But I don't mind the double tone. Every Sunday morning? Awesome! And no, I get my nails done. This is like the weirdest conversation ever sprung up on Twitch. For me. Have to catch Jim Lee on Sundays. Ah, no, terrible. Don't talk about buildings. No buildings. Unless you want to make me cry. Look, hey, I used a ruler for a wings. Y'all, give me a break. Stress out talking about buildings. Oops. Hair. I can talk about hair. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, the wings looking, they're looking pretty good. That's somewhat decent. Just more of a red there. Friends. Thank you. Dawn is killing it. Girl has some mad skills. I believe she's doing a show right now or just finished a show. I'm not sure. And she just moved to doing digital colors too. And I'm like, is there anything you can't do? I mean, seriously? Just gonna be over here. You're awesome. High fives. She's incredibly talented and super sweet and humble. It's ridiculous. She's amazing. Super Trooper Truth's going out, though. Ah! There's motion in my backyard! Probably my husband. Yeah, I've been doing the Facebook Live stuff a lot more. Yeah, I've met Dawn. I met her and like when she was first breaking into comics and stuff, super, super sweet gal. And then of course I've run into her at shows and stuff. Completely amazing. So talented. Oh, sorry. I was coloring off frame. My bad. I'm going to back this up now. You guys can kind of see more of what I'm working on. I was coloring this part in. some leaves are starting to look good. And what I'm looking for right now are hopefully going to be right here.
Nope.
Aw, Riona! Yay! Yes, I have. I've met actually the most recent Pensacon. I had, what's that guy's name? Come up to my table and I totally like fangirled out at him and was like, hello, and was dumb. And he didn't even blink twice at me. He just go over there like, being a nerd. And it was cool though. He was a really cool guy. What is this actor's name? I'm drawing a blank. He was on Star Trek. He played the robotic doctor. No, not Data. He was the voice of Baymax. He was and been in a lot of films. Now I'm just going in here with a fluorescent orange. Yes, yes, yes. What is his name? He came up to my table at Pensacon and he was so sweet. And, you know, we chatted for a little bit because he had some ideas and stuff. So he was wanting to understand the comic book process. And I was like, okay. And, you know, with Pensacon being a smaller show and me being a comic book guest, I'm able to access the green room where, you know, the celebrities are. I actually stood in line behind the other guy who dresses up at a lot of cons. He was in Doctor Who. He was not a doctor, but he was in Doctor Who. I'm so bad at names. I'm terrible at names. Yes, thank you. And he was just super nice. And I was like, I told him, I said, well, my dad is a huge fan. So am I. And my dad's probably going to crap his pants when he finds out I'm standing here talking to you. The man did not even blink. He just got out his picture and said, what's your dad's name? And I was just like, I'm over here like freaking out. Like, oh my God, oh my God. And he's like, nope, just going to write it all out for you. So, you know, they've seen it all, been told it all. Lord knows what they've experienced at shows. The woman who played River on The Doctor, I've seen her walking. And she's actually one I've been stunned by. She's so beautiful in person. Lynn, it's not just an outer beauty. It's like an inner beauty that shines and a star quality that hits you like a ton of bricks. It's crazy. We've run into a whole lot of Walking Dead cast. Just all kinds of stuff. So, I mean, there are opportunities where you do meet celebrities. You run into them and stuff like that at shows. How often do you use photo references for your drawings? Do you ever use photo reference? I do use photo references. I'm not opposed to them. This was actually, this post here itself was inspired by an app called Art. What's it called? Come here. I'm going to find it on my phone. You guys can look at it. Art Pose. And you can get it on your phone. You can see it. And it basically has 3D. There's Art Pose. There's a regular one that has a dude. And then there's one with a female. And then you can go here and look. You can click on something. You can move them all around. Oh, I'm doing a thing. Hey, I'm going to do it this way. Or you can click on the body and they have pre-done poses. I don't copy the poses completely because these models don't have a lot of personality. I mean, he's like, what's up? I mean, not really much going on there. But you can change the camera angle, which is pretty neat. You can also, what is it? Do like musculature so you can see the muscles. You can make them really bulky or really scrawny, but it's your typical male-female body sizes. You can go far away or up close. You can even change the lighting and give them hair. You can go through and move them around. The poses, I mean, like I said, the poses are not the best. They're still static, but they're really good for like quick reference when you need some inspiration. And they had one like this, though I think like this leg was extended out. This one was something here, and I just was like, okay, I'm going to bend it so I have a nice S curve. Because that's whenever I draw women, I try to get a nice flowy curve that goes along the paper. Yeah, no problem. I really like that app, especially when traveling. I've got them here on my phone, Art Pose and Art Pose FE. And, you know, sometimes when you're doing commissions and you go a little brain dead after a while, you're just like sitting there going, I can't even, and you're drawing the same thing over and over again. It's really good to help kind of give you a refresher. Again, like I said, I wouldn't copy verbatim because you want to add a little personality to your figures and stuff. But if you need just a little something, something, or to do a warm up or something like that, it's a good little reference tool. So you're welcome. Yeah, it's like I said, it's a good launching pad. There's also, there's a website called posemaniacs.com or .org. That's also a really good one. There's, of course, you can look on Google and look for references on there. There you are. But there's all kinds of places where you can go and look to try to find a good reference. And I don't know if you guys can even see it, but when I posted a photo, I've got my references over here to the left, and I'm actually looking at what Mercy looks like, and I have them taped up on my desk. So, you know, granted, she's not in this particular pose, but since I don't play the game and I'm not overly familiar with the character, I have that around me. I don't think that using references is a negative thing. Some people kind of look down on it and maybe poo-poo a little bit, but I think that you're kind of shooting yourself in the foot if you don't look around yourself. But the best reference tool is life. Just going out and drawing life. Yeah, you can Google stuff and find stuff that way. No, not yellow green. I can't find my fluorescent yellow. Which is what I need really, really bad. Ah. Where did I go? I apologize, guys. Because of my traveling, I am not organized. Thank you. 3 months to unpack, pretty much. Probably find it after the stream, which I'll use the fluorescent yellow to come in here and add light on here. I would say I use Google more to reference buildings and stuff, because as you heard, buildings are my favorite, not really. So I need more help with landscapes and things like that. Loves them so much. That's what my new art book's gonna be, just buildings. Not. No, please don't. And what I'm doing now is I'm just using this charcoal to render some, but also plot where I'm gonna put my paint. They've done the skyscrapers. thanks for the challenge there, Simone. Yep. Not shady at all there, girl. I was like, someone was like, well, do you always have to draw women? Why can't you draw something else? And I'm like, I haven't drawn dudes. It's really pretty much buildings that are a pain in the butt right now. Like even landscapes with trees and stuff, I'm pretty good at that. You know, I just did a Jungle Book. That was fine. But it was when I had to do the city stuff that I was over there whining in the corner like, I can't do it. I did it. Right? Hey, if it's not a challenge, then what's the point, right? what to whine at you. I can't do it! Not, although that was when I was really getting into comics, so I know of the whole thing. Because I mean, that was Image Comics and stuff were the bomb in it, and I loved the artwork in those books, and that's what got me into comics, really. It was just all the detail, and I guess that's why I these days, whenever I do draw, I am like hyper detailed. It's because I just love that whole look that the 90s comics had, and I know that kind of dates me, but I loved that stuff. That was my jam. Yeah, I'll have to watch it. I'll have to check it out. Definitely. My dog's over there being a spaz. I can hear her. Well, you guys, now I'm just doing like small renders that's really not showing up on the screen. And it's going to be getting late here. So I will show you. It's super bright, sorry. Kind of what's going on here. So far, can't see all right, you stupid. There we go. It's not so bright. She's coming along. Yep, too close. Okay. Well, now you get an idea. It's too fast. Slower. Anyway, it's late here. It's gonna be. I mean, it is only 10:15, but I'm getting sleepy. It's been a long day, and my kids are going to wake me up early because of school. So thank you guys for hanging out. It's really just small detailing. It's so very hard to see on here. But again, thank you for hanging out. Woo! Keeping me company while I work on this. And y'all have a good night.